In this video, we are going to see conditional statements in PHP. So some of the conditional statements are if else statement, if else statement, then switch statement, then conditional statement. That is three conditional statements. Now, so when you want to perform this condition, when you want to check some expression, and based on that, you may want to express a set of conditions, or if that becomes false, if that condition is not satisfied, then you may want to execute some other conditions. That is taking decisions. So in that case, these statements will be of use. So here, let us see, this is the syntax. If conditional expression, if this condition, whatever condition you have given, if it is true, then the block of code within this curly braces will be executed. Else, if this is false, then this will not be executed. Automatically, after this braces, whatever is the statement, that will be executed. So for example, if $uname, it's a variable, okay? If that is equal to, the value that is equal to guess, then this statement will be executed. There is echo welcome to the guest, or else this statement will not be executed. So this is a simple statement. So this will execute only if this condition given is true. The next one is, if the condition is true, if the condition becomes false, then we may want to execute some other set of conditions. So either this or that. In that case, we go for if-else condition. So here, if, then the expression, if this is true, the expression given is true, then this set of. If it becomes false, this. So either of this only executed. In this case, we go for if-else condition. So for example, if username equal to guest, it is true, then welcome to the guest page. Else, permission denied. It says that permission denied. And after this curly braces, whatever it is, that will be executed. So only either one of these echo statements will be printed based on the condition. Then else if, when you want to check multiple conditional statements, then you go for else if statement. So what is the syntax? If, then you will be giving condition. And if it is true, this will be executed. Else, if this is not true, then you check for another condition. If that condition is true, then this statement will be executed. Else, the statement will be executed. So the first here will be executed. So for example, let us take an example. Username. If username is equal to admin, then welcome to the admin page. If it is true, it will be executed. Else, we check for another one, whether it is admin or guest. So guest means you print some value, else you print welcome back and then username. So this is another example for multiple condition checking. Now we'll go to the ternary operator. What is ternary operator? We use three operators here, so we call it as a ternary operator. So this is one condition. All the three things are in the same expression. That is, instead of if else, we have, see here, testing conditions. And if this is true, after this question mark, whatever is given, that will be executed. If it is false, then after this colon, whatever is there, that will be executed. So that's the meaning of this. So we'll see the ternary operator example. A small example. Here, a variable called logged in is there, and if we have assigned some true value to boolean value, now this has become a boolean variable. So another variable called user, where we have assigned the value. Now we check the value. But if banner, we have assigned the variable, and this variable will have a value returned by this if else. So what it is do? This is the ternary operator. Here we check the value. If logged in, if this variable is equal to true, then this will be executed. That this value is returned to the banner. Okay, welcome back $user. So that admin will be substituted and that will be stored in banner. Else, this message, please log in, that will be stored in banner. Now, when you execute the statement, the echo banner, whatever is stored in banner will be displayed. But what that value is based on these conditions. If this is equal to true, then this will be assigned to banner. Else, this message will be assigned to banner. So here it is true, so answer is welcome back admin. The next one what we are going to see is switch statement. So switch is similar to our if multiple conditions. So instead of that, you can go for switch statement. So it's very common to have an expression such as a variable for which you want to execute different code. For a single variable, there may be cases. Say for example, you may want to check whether the day is Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. So there are so many values for a particular day. So in that case, you can go for a, instead of writing it plus, you can go for a switch statement. If it is Monday, what you have to do? If it is Tuesday, what you have to do? If it is Wednesday, then what you have, like that. So if a particular variable can have more than 1, 2, or 3 values, then you can go for a switch statement. And based on that, you may want to take a decision. Definitely, you can go for a switch statement. So we'll see here. This is an example for if class. And for the same, we have given it a switch statement. Let us take first the if class. If action is equal to add. So for example, you may want to do some actions that addition, multiplication, subtraction, and all. So you are getting the, if you are getting the value of this action, if it is equal to add, then you are giving echo perform action for adding, etc. And else, if action is equal to modify, perform actions for modifying. Else, if action equal to delete, then you do this. So here, the same thing can be written in switch statement, like switch dollar action. So after the keyword switch, the dollar inside that, you will be giving the variable for which you want to build the conditions. Then open curly braces, case, then you give that. What will be the value for that? What will be the action? What will be the value passed to this action? So here add, then colon. Here you have to give the colon, case, then the value for this, then colon. Then you write what acceptable PHP statements. Okay, correct syntax of the PHP statement here. Then you have to give a break. You have to write a break, because after this, it is over. It has to come out. If you don't give break, what it will do add, it will do modify, and then it will do delete. So, but what is our aim is to do any one of this. So in that case, you have to give a break for all the case. To modify, after the echo, you have to give a break like this. Then finally, close it with the curly braces. So once again, we will see that the if class, the keyword is if, then within bracket, you have to give the conditions. If it is true, then this will be executed. Else, it will be executed. So what are all the keywords? If is a keyword, within bracket, you have to give the condition. Then if that is true, then within the curly flowery braces, you have to give the set of statements to be executed. If it is true, then you have to give the keyword else. Then open the curly braces and give the set of statements which has to be executed if it is false. And close the flowery braces. Then this is what the general syntax as we have seen. For else if condition curly braces code to be executed, then close the curly braces. Then you have to give else if without any space between else and if together. Else if, then again conditions and so on. Then else and so on. Now if it is for switch case, for the ternary operator, here you give the expressions, then question mark, and then the if statement which is to be executed, if it is true, then put the colon, then statement to be executed if it is false. Like this. So you can give within the bracket the expression and then question mark, the answer true, this is answer for false, and so on. Now for the switch statement, the keyword is switch, and then within bracket you give the variable, not the expression, the variable, and then open curly braces and close to curly. Within that you write this case, then the value for this variable, colon, then you give the permitted PHP statements, then break. Yeah, all the statements must end with semicolon that we have already seen. All the statements in the PHP should end with the semicolon. Finally, close it. Now this is for breaking. If I want to break from the particular code, so how to do that? If you want only the code in the matching block to execute, you can place a break keyword at the end of that block. When PHP comes across the break keyword, processing jumps to the next line after the entire switch statement. So if you see what happens when there are no break keywords, we'll see that. As I have already told you that you have to give a break statement, or else it will execute all this, which is not the necessary thing which we need in this. So which is wrong. So here, let us say action equal to assemble order. Now this value is passed here. So first itself it satisfied and it executes this. Since there is no break, this also will be get executed. See, you can see that perform actions for order assembly, perform actions for packaging, and in this for shipping. All these things will be printed. Whereas this is not at all necessary for us. We want to print only this. Okay, if it is satisfied, only the first thing has to be there. So in order to obtain the expected result, you have to give a break. Even if this will not give you error, logically it is error. Syntactically, it is not error. It does not give any error. Now, default. The case statement also provides a way to do something if none of the other cases match. So for example, I am passing a value which does not match all these things. The value which I am passing is not an assemble order, not a package, not a ship. In that case, you can give a default value. So there is a keyword called default in which will be executed if none of the cases are satisfied. So example here, the action add modify direct. If the key, if the information which I am passing, for example, insert, I am passing the value insert here, which is not there, add modify delete. All these things are not matching with my insert. In that case, if you don't give that, error will come. So instead, I want to give default. So give the keyword default and then colon, then you print something. Action must be either this, or that. So this is one way of catching the error so that you are avoiding the error. So here, another one, instead of curly braces, you can go for this syntax, where after this action, you put the colon and then finally end switch. Whereas if you see here, we don't have a colon here. Instead, we have the curly braces and closing. This is one syntax. Alternatively, you can adopt this syntax also, where you have this colon, then other things are as usual. Then, but finally, you have to give end switch and semicolon.